Hey, welcome back to Mechanical Pros. Today we're gonna be learning about greasing motors. Got Brian with me here. Brian, tell me what we're looking at.
Yeah, what we've got here is a Baldor 25 horsepower motor that we pulled out of an old air handler. Now this motor had failed because the bearings had failed on it. The customer chose, because of downtime and inventory, they had a motor there. We just changed it for them. We're gonna rebuild this motor bearings for them and put it back in their shop. That'll be on a video to come. Today, what we're gonna talk about is greasing your motor bearings, how frequent to grease them, the grease to use, best practices. And we're gonna start by going over something I picked up looking at the internet that I knew this would be a high number. I had no idea how high the number was, but they say 40% of bearing failures are due to greasing the bearings, whether it's too much grease, not enough grease, wrong type of grease. So 40% of the bearings out there fail before their lifespan, all because of the way they're getting maintained by maintenance shop or whoever happens, or maybe they never get greased. You know, you see that a lot too. So that was kind of shocking. I knew it would be a high number. I didn't think it'd be that high, but pretty eye-opening, and that's probably the reason we're gonna find out that this one failed as well. So what we're gonna talk about is the best practice for it. So you'll hear a lot of different things from motor manufacturers. You grease them every 6 months, grease them every year, put this much grease. Well, I got a grease gun here with a handle, right? So I could go and do a lot of research and figure out how much grease actually comes out of this thing every time I squeeze the handle. But you know, I live in the real world where I've got things I've got to do and I got to get shit done. So we're gonna talk about the easiest way to do it, where you know when you walk away from it, not only do you have the proper amount of grease in it, you've gotten all the old grease out, there's no question about it. So the way we like to do it is we pull the grease plug. So on the bottom, right in this housing, is where our bearing is living, right? Small bearing is right in this cap. So you got your grease zert on top, this is where we would add our grease. On the bottom right here is a grease plug. We're gonna go ahead and remove that plug. Now I've gone ahead and loosened this up and I'll show you guys why. This is a slotted screw for a flat screwdriver. If I were to try to take it out without loosening it first with this one, I'd strip it. That is a very unforgiving screw, right? So you get your slotted screwdriver and if it's not quite big enough and it's in there really tight, well, we all know what's gonna happen. It's gonna round that out and then you're never getting it out. So what I like to do is use a large screwdriver with a big wide blade that's thick, that it fits snug in there and I can get a lot of torque on it. Now this sitting on the ground, sometimes you may have to unbolt it and swing it on its stand to be able to get to that. But believe me, it's worth it. So we removed our cap, now we got that out. Now we're gonna start adding grease and we're gonna keep adding grease until we see our new grease start pouring out of the bottom of this grease plug. By doing that, we know that we've displaced all of that old grease out of there that's probably been overheated, who knows what's happened to it, and we filled this cap with the appropriate amount of new grease, and we know we didn't put so much grease in it that it busts the seal on the bearing because it's gonna come out of this plug before it destroys our bearing, right? So we'll go ahead and start doing that. The grease I'm using is a Mobil 1 grease. It's called EM, electric motor. Very crucial that you use the right kind of grease, and not only that, don't ever mix two types of greases. If you mix the two types of greases that are not similar, it'll cause the grease to liquefy in there and damage your bearing. So, you know what I like to use to do? These aren't that expensive. I'd always carry one that had my electric motor grease on it, and then I'd carry another one that I might use to grease pillow block bearings or something like that. Just don't mix them up. Always make sure you're using electric motor grease for your electric motor. If you have any questions, every motor's gonna have a data plate on it. You can Google that manufacturer and you'll find literature on the appropriate type of grease to find online, or you could call the parts house where you bought it, the vendor you bought it from. If you want to call direct to the manufacturer, it's just super critical to use the right type of grease, because it's if anybody's changed bearings in a motor, you know, it's not the hardest job in the world, but it's a lot harder than greasing a motor, I can tell you that. So we'll go ahead and start greasing it and we'll see what we get out of this guy. Now again, this one failed in the field, so I'm kind of anxious to see what this looks like as we start pushing it out. I've got a blue grease in this grease gun, which is that Mobil 1 grease. It looks like so far we're still not getting anything out of there. So there it starts coming. You see how black and discolored that is? I don't know how well that camera's picking that up, right? Mm-hmm. That doesn't look good. So even if this motor had been running, shutting it off, de-energizing, lockout, tagout, and I do this until I start seeing my new grease coming through, which will be a blue-colored grease. Looks like I'm still getting black, maybe starting to get a little bit of change in the color. Yeah, it looks like it's starting to get blue now. Keep going. Now you might use a half a tube of grease on one motor. There you see, now we've changed to blue. So now I know 100% I've got all brand new grease in here. I've pushed that old grease out of there, and now I can put my plug back in. Obviously, it's a messy job, so you want to have a rag under there. Clean your job site up for your customer. And we're just going to put our plug back in there. It's always the easiest thing. That's, I guess, some of the most trouble there.
So, Brian, that plug, how many plugs do you think people actually take out the grease?
Very few. So if you come one and you go and you try to take it out and it's stuck, you know, it's, and the reason why it's gotten so damn hot, it sees that plug in there. And that's when you got to be really careful, because if you strip it out, these are just casting. It's very hard to tap and thread a new one in there. So always be careful. And sometimes you just can't get them out. But if you take your time, you know, I'd love to say throw some heat on it, but obviously we do not want to heat our bearing up. So you're going to take your time, use some WD, some Kroll oil, soak it, do what you can. Sometimes you just can't get them out. And then now if we run into that situation, if you can leave the motor down, maybe they've got a backup and you can run it. You take these four bolts, pull this whole motor cap out where you can get it apart and work on it a little better, get it up on a stand to work on. So. Now, it's easier said than done getting that grease plug out, but if you can get it out and you can do it that way, you can walk away from it knowing 100% that motor's got brand new grease in it. There's nothing old in there. The bearing is now protected. And if it says to grease this motor through the IOM, I would always refer to the IOM on the motor. People will say every 3 months. Some guys, every time they inspect it, they'll come put four squirts in there. Well, that's all good, but the old grease is still in there. So what you're doing is packing it and you're going to blow the seal out on that bearing. So super critical to get that plug out there to flush it with new grease.
So one another thing, that's a great explanation, mm-hmm. but another thing I always hear you guys talking about is, are they sealed bearings or are they grease bearings?
Yep.
So do they come pre-grease and you don't have to add grease to it, or does grease have to be added?
That's a great question. This is going to answer that question for you. If you walk up on a motor, it's a new jet, you're not going to know. Just sometimes they'll put this zert in there, but it's got a grease bearing in it. So when you pump it in there, it's just filling that motor cavity up. So if you don't know, refer to the data tag, call the manufacturer, Google it, Google the part number, and you'll find that information. But that is a critical thing. If it's a sealed bearing, you're not necessarily hurting it by putting grease, but you're just packing all that grease inside your electric motor. And you don't want to do that. It's going to shorten the lifespan of it. Really good question. Ideally, you have a bearing you can grease, because if you maintain it properly, it's going to last a lot longer than a sealed bearing will. But, you know, there's a good probably 30, 40% of the motors out there in this size could have sealed bearings in them. And you just, visually, you're not going to know. You need to do the research to find out.
Perfect. So I got a front bearing and a back bearing.
That's
I want
right.
to do the same process.
Absolutely. The reason I did it on the back is you can see it a little better. We got a pulley on the front of this, but behind that pulley is the exact same setup. The shaft is sticking out of it, but you still got a zert and you got a grease plug right below it. Front end's a little tougher because you do have that pulley to work with. That's why sometimes it's better to take it loose, spin it to the side, off the fan sled or whatever, so you can get up under there and get it. There are times you may have to take the pulley off. You know, those are sometimes easier said than done, but ideally it's a motor this size or smaller, and you can, you know, it's a 25 horse motor, but I can still by myself spin it and work on it and do things. So
what about greasing a bearing while the motor's running?
I would not grease a bearing while the motor's running.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
Don't get close to it. You're gonna hurt yourself. Yeah. Just always lock out, tag out.
Especially on the shaft side, you can get tangled up around that. That's a huge, huge danger.
That is a death trap right there.
Yeah.
That's a great point, John. Do not ever work on an electric motor without having it locked and tagged out.
Yeah. All right, that's great. Okay. Thanks. I learned something, Brian. All right, hope that was good for you. If you liked it, hit that like, hit the subscribe, and check us out for more videos from Mechanical Pros.
Yeah.